Hi, I'm Patricia Anthony, and welcome to Bethel Park TV Art Exhibition. Today, we're visiting the McMurray Art League.
Hello there. My name is Sandy Conley, and I'm co-president along with Teresa Bozo of the McMurray Art League. And we are filming from the McMurray Art League studio, which is located in the McDowell Shops south of Donaldson's Crossroads, just a bit. If you know where the Kmart and the Atria's restaurant are, we're very close to that. And we also have a brand new sign out front that that shows exactly where we are. 7 years ago was when we first were able to use this space. It was through the generosity of one of our members, Bunky Masitis, who made the arrangements with her husband, who owns this shopping center, to allow us to use this space. And we continue to use this space in honor of Bunky's memory. This is our 45th year of existence. One of our original members, Carol Sue Dukestein, is here, and today is going to tell us a little bit about the history of McMurray Art League. So I'd like to pass this along to Carol Sue.
I'm Carol Sue Dukestein. I'm the first original member, not a founder, but the first original member of the Art League. I've been active in the Art League for 45 years, and I continue to be. This year I'm vice president. 45 years ago, if you were standing where I'm standing now, you'd be surrounded by a flock of sheep, because there wasn't much in Peters Township at that time. This was McDowell's sheep farm up here. The Art League was one of the first civic organizations to organize. When I heard about it, I was just a beginning artist. I had two little kids. I had been trying to learn to oil paint on my own. I was thrilled to have an outlet and people of like-minded ideas. When we first started the league, we met all over the place. We met at churches, at Boy Scout houses, the VFW, all kinds of places. And we had classes the same way. We continue to have classes. Our classes are taught in this room. We have well-known instructors, Christine Swan, Barry Jeter, Frank Webb. We also have people in the league who teach. I teach. Some of the programs we started early on were a scholarship for a senior to go on to art school. It started out at around $300. Now we give $500. We've given thousands of dollars. This has been ongoing for 45 years. The other thing that we did is that we continue to support the library. All the paintings that are hung in the shows that the Art League has at the library and has had for years and years and years, 10% goes to the library. One of our interests is in selling our work. One of our interests is in making artists progress. We hope that if you are interested, you would join the league. It's $24 a year, and you don't have to do anything except come up with the $24. After the first of the year, when we start up again in February, it will be $12 for a half year. If you wish to exhibit in our May show, you must be a member. But we would encourage you to come if you're interested, if you like art. We are particularly interested in three-dimensional art now that we have a space of our own to sell, and two-dimensional art, cards, and that type of thing. So we encourage you to come to a meeting, see what we're about, come to a show. This is my artwork behind me. I work primarily in watercolor and acrylic. I like to do landscapes. I'm an outdoor person by nature. Since I've retired from commercial art, I've been doing some birds and wildlife paintings. But years ago, when my kids were of elementary school age, I used to take them with me to the seaside shows like at Atlantic City and Penn State and Three Rivers and places like that. And the deal was they hauled and then they could go do what they wanted. And I had cheap help for the art shows. this would be typical of my work. Lately, I have been working and teaching colored pencil. Kids have been drawing in colored pencil for years, but to make it a fine art, the art companies have made them more permanent and color fast. And so you get results like this. This is all done in pencil, and it's more unique than just making a drawing with a colored pencil. This, I'm so thrilled with, is Sandy. When we decided to have the 45th anniversary, the Art League decided that the three old members that were still active, Carolyn Johnson, Tina Wagner, and myself, that they would get three portrait artists from the League to do our portraits. Mine was done by Sandy, and I just love it.
Hi, I'm Connie Clutter from Washington, PA, and I started drawing about 10 years ago. And at that time, I became interested because I had gone to a local art show like What's Here Today, and I was really inspired by the artwork and the artists. I started drawing and then continued to want to do more painting. I did painting in pastel and watercolor when I started out and took classes down at the Carnegie Museum of Art. It was a little while after I had been taking those classes, then another artist friend introduced me to the McMurray Art League and thought it would be something I'd be interested in. They have classes, and also at the time being able to show your work and also to sell it, which I hadn't really considered. I joined at that point and have been enjoying the Art League ever since. I take classes here. It really has been a help, especially taking from the great artists we have here. It has really helped me artistically, and I think it's really helping me to grow. This particular painting is one that Bert Silverman is a realist painter. He does watercolor on Bristol board, and that's something that I was trying to work on and really enjoy. The African violet that's in the picture, a couple years ago, my husband and I bought a new house, and the owners that had lived there left this. I'm not very good. I don't have a green thumb, and I was happy that it really was blooming and beautiful, and that was something I just wanted to capture in the painting. I actually grew up right outside of Canonsburg, and we lived on a cattle farm. My father raised beef cattle, and something I've always been intrigued by are the farms in the area. This one actually happened to be out in Ligonier, and I was really drawn to the contrast of the white barns against the mountains there. And then this particular painting, I had been in a botanical garden, and this little frog was really cute. He kept going up to get air, and the colors were really beautiful on him. It's just something you don't really see very often, and that's what I was trying to capture in this painting. I also do some photography, and in these pictures you'll see this is actually a picture of the family farm and where I grew up. I also do some other landscapes and sunsets, and I've also tried to capture the different seasons too, and along the tree line on the top of our hill. It's been really great to be able to capture that.
Hi, my name is Linda Saxa, and I belong to the McMurray Art League. I've been a member for many years and am thrilled to be here because of the variety of things that go on here, from beginners to very experienced people to classes to meetings where you hear lectures. And we also have an open studio on Tuesdays when we don't have instructions, and that is a time when artists can get together and do their own thing but with other people around, and that's a very special thing to do. I do like to do some sketching, some realistic, but when I do realistic, I work very loose and very colorful. But now I prefer to do more of a non-objective abstract art, and this is one of my paintings over here, and it's called Earth Coral. And because I work very dark with my paints, I always have to be careful on getting some lightness to them. And on this one, I painted it very darkly, and then I went back and did some stencil work. So all these coral kind of lines that you see in there are done with a stencil. And the stencil was an x-ray of my dog's broken leg, and I used a wood-burning tool, and I, on the x-ray, I did all these little squiggles with the tool, and that's much easier to do with a wood-burning tool than a X-Acto knife. Then I placed those on top of the painting, used a wet toothbrush, and held it very still, and rubbed the toothbrush over the stencil, used a wet dry paper towel, and patted that off, and that pulled the paint off of the painting. And then you have to make sure that the X-ray or the acetate is dry and put it in different places or repeat the same thing. And I did that until I had different depth in the painting. And that's how I did that painting. And then little splatters at the end. This painting was done around the same time. And it was a painting that used more of a watery look to it. So I started out with a wet background. And you can see the lighter colors in the back flowed in with the water. Then after that dried, I put darker paint on, and I would turn the painting and let it run different directions. And as it went in different directions, I decided to encourage it by using my brush and encouraged all these little wiggly lines. And this painting is called Aquatic Imagery because it reminded me of underwater. But did I plan that at the beginning? No, I didn't. When I paint, sometimes I like to go in the direction that I was started and finish the painting that way. But there are other times where I kind of like the painting to let me go and lead me, and I just kind of guide the paint, but the painting guides me also. A lot of paintings that I do, I start out with photographs. Sometimes I'm outside and I take the photographs, and other times they're people studies. I do like to do people studies, figure studies. But this one, I was sitting on a flat rock in Mingo Creek, and it was all muddy, and everything was very browns. But it was a sunny day, and I enjoyed listening to the water as it went around the rocks and hit the other rocks. And actually, some of these areas are where the rocks were, and the in-between areas were where the water flowed. I didn't want to do it in browns. I like when I look at something, I like to imagine or see more color than is really there to most people. And I just start working. So that started out as a rock in a stream, but it grew on its own into different colors and layers. And when I finished it, I looked at it and decided to title it Blue Yolks. So I like to do things a little bit different, kind of get a different edge on things, and use a lot of color. The thing I like about McMurray Art League is the variety of things, and that our show is here for the first time in our own studio, and we have things from $2 to several $100s, so there's something for everyone. Anyone who is interested in coming to the McMurray Art League would really have a good time, because there's a lot of good people, a lot of good things going on. And if you aren't interested in doing art, it's a great place to come and enjoy art and to buy art.
I'm Laura Mooney, and I've been with McMurray Art League about 9 years. Currently, I'm the newsletter editor, and I'm a student at Community College of Allegheny County. My major is graphic communications, and I'll be graduating in December. I've been an artist since about sixth grade, and I really never pursued it as a career, but I've always wanted to, and I took a number of years off, just sort of dabbled here and there with things. I discovered McMurray Art League when I was shopping at Trax Farm one day, and there was a class out there, and I was interested in the paintings that people were doing, and I spoke to some of the women there, and they told me about the league, and I'd always been interested in watercolor. So I decided to join the league, and I found it to be very supportive and a very friendly atmosphere, and the teachers were awesome, and there's such an opportunity to participate in the shows and selling your artwork and all phases of art, and it's just been a really good group of people to be with. I did this picture of my cat during the summer break from school here at the studio, and it was just sort of an afterthought. I was pretty much cleaning up that day, and I just had a scrap of paper, and I just started drawing, and I was pretty pleased how it turned out. It's only the second pastel I did. So I'm just really pleased with the opportunities that present themselves through McMurray Art League, and I thank you for your time.
Okay, I'm going to talk about an event we held almost a year ago. It's called the Lush Brush. 10 McMurray Art League members came together here at the studio to work on a small 8x10 piece, such as what I'm holding. And the theme for the evening was Southwest Pennsylvania. Each of us was supposed to come prepared to do a painting of something in Southwest Pennsylvania. We would drink wine, eat hors d'oeuvres, and paint. And these are the results of that evening, so you can see the wine didn't affect us too much. I guess I want to just kind of go through some of these paintings and show you the results of our evening. This is the Wright House, I believe it's Washington County, by member Jeannie Polizano. Behind it is a painting of the Little Theater, which is just across Route 19 from our studio here. This is St. Luke's Church, I believe it's Scott Township. Next to it is Simmons Farm on Route 19. Behind it is a painting of the Laurel Flower, which is the, I guess, the state flower of Pennsylvania. Behind it, we have a covered bridge. This one is at Meadowcroft. This is the Ebenezer Bridge in Mingo Park in Washington County. Behind it is just a very typical Southwest Pennsylvania scene, water and woods. We had a couple other paintings that have sold because the purpose of the Lush Brush event was not just to get people together, even though that was one of the goals. The purpose was to raise money for our new sign on our building here in Peters Township. Each of these little paintings sells for a little price of $50. They are all originals and available for sale here in the studio. So stop by to check out our Lush Brush little paintings.
Hi, my name's Teresa Bozo. I'm one of the older members, but I'm started the league when I retired. I finally had time to explore the field of art, which I always was interested in. And I'm an amateur, but thanks to the league, they have the most wonderful classes. And then we get such well-known artists, instructors, and I probably have taken most of the classes offered. And one of the things we added to our fall show, we invited our instructors to put something, some of our instructors put something in the show to show the people who where we got some of the things that we're showing here. We have such wonderful classes at such reasonable prices because the artists are willing to work with a community group like ours to get them exposed to the arts. And if you look at some of these paintings, you can see the quality of the work. And a lot of the painters we have in our show are renowned painters, not just here in Peters Township or Western Pennsylvania, but all through the United States. And the classes, as I said, are extremely reasonable. We have maybe a six-hour class for $30 a person. That's $5 an hour to get an artist that sells their work for thousands of dollars and their expertise. But one of the things that this art league does, they not only help us develop our skills and feed that part of our souls about art, but the members themselves are wonderful. And they too feed part of our souls with their friendship and their dedication to this organization and working together. And it's just something about it. I've been involved now for 8 years, and I just can't begin to tell you all the wonderful experiences that you can get by being a member of this art league. These are some of the pieces of artwork that I entered into our fall show. I dabble with photography, and this picture is a photograph, and I took gourds and set them up and just tried to get a picture that would show their unique color and shapes. And the title of that, It's Good to Be Different. And I kind of find that interesting to play with those pieces and arrange them. The two bottom paintings are watercolors. And I'm one of those people, I wish I could be like some of these artists that are very loose and their colors flow. I'm one of those people that gets it real tight, as you can see. And I kind of start with my work and try to get the look of the flowers. And for me, I love doing flowers and still lifes because I enjoy setting it up and designing the composition and then going back and putting in the details. And so this is a type of work that I do. This is a pastel that we did in a class, actually, with an artist from Ireland, a pastel artist. And he had us do this as an assignment. And I loved the bright colors and the different shapes in this painting.
Hi, I'm Michaeline Penzik. I live in Mount Lebanon. I joined McMurray Art League about 12 years ago on the invitation of a friend from Mount Lebanon. We don't have an art league up north, so had to come down south here. I've painted, drawn, crafted things all my life. It's just something I love doing and can't imagine not doing it. In the past, I've worked in oil, acrylic, and pencil, and I'd say for the last probably 12 to 15 years, I've concentrated on watercolor. And when I started watercolor, I did it because I didn't have a studio, and I was working on my dining room table, and it had to be cleared off every evening. Well, now I do have a studio, and I'm still doing watercolor because I've really gotten into it, and I really love it. The possibilities are endless. It's really a very sophisticated medium. I do have things that I like to paint, but I also experiment all the time. So this little painting here is very much an experiment. It started out by me drawing these ellipses with a silver marker and then filling in with colors that were variations on red and purple. And it's just something that's fun to do, and it helps me learn about color, and I end up with a fun little painting. I also sort of deviate from the subject that I like most, which is architecture, to do things like these landscapes. And these are prints of the original. The original was actually bigger than this. But again, I was just trying to see if I could paint trees and colors. And as I said, these are prints. They're giclée prints. They're high-quality prints. You take the original, you scan it into a computer. Well, actually, I don't. Someone does this for me. They scan it into a computer and then print it out on a high-quality printer using very light, fast inks. The original is hanging in our home because I really like this, the results of this experiment. My best sellers, if I can call them that, are doors. And I started with this door. And this is a print of the original. The original was probably about three times as big. And I did this door as a commission for my niece who was graduating from college. I was asked to do a painting for her. And I thought about what might actually have some meaning for her. I didn't want to do a scene that she would look at and just sort of put away. So I came up with the idea of doing something from our family heritage. My mom was born in Eastern Poland, or what was Eastern Poland before the Second World War. The town she was born in is now part of the Ukraine. And there's a big city near where she was born called Lviv now. Lviv dates, the city charter of Lviv dates from the 13th century. And the marketplace in Lviv is gorgeous. This is one of the doors of the buildings on the marketplace. I've sold more prints of this door than any other. I work from photographs. My mom and sister went back to Lviv in, I think it was about 2005, and my sister took photos of these doors. And it's the detail, I think, that attracts people. Buildings are a record of history, culture, and time, and you look at this and you know it wasn't built in 2010, and you know someone was really proud of their home when they made this door for themselves. But I don't only do doors from other parts of the world, even though right now I'm working on a door from Lima, Peru, and I've done three doors from Lviv. I actually have family members and friends now sending me pictures from all over because they know I paint doors. I also paint doors here in Pittsburgh and Western Pennsylvania. So this door, for example, is St. Adalbert's Church on the south side of Pittsburgh. It's a historic landmark, and I go and I take a photograph, and I try to get there on a day where the light is good so that I get some nice shadows and light on the door, and I try to capture that in the painting. The problem with the south side is that the streets are narrow, so I really can't get too far away from it. So that sometimes dictates the perspective I have. But I'm working from a photograph, and I blow it up to the size that I want to work with. And this is not a representational, very realistic representation. I've left out details. I've changed things. But you'd recognize it at St. Adalbert's door. I also have done the door of Carnegie Library in Carnegie. It's a beautiful building. I've done doors such as an old shed door on a barn in Butler County. Those barns aren't going to be around for much longer, and it's wonderful to have a record of them. In my library of things to paint, there's an old garage on Route 88, Fellers, that I'd love to draw. And I don't know how many other photographs I have, so I have a backlog of paintings to do. I do sell my work here at McMurray Art League Studio and elsewhere. If you'd be interested in talking to me about a commission, I'd be glad to talk to you. And thank you for the opportunity to talk about my art.
My name's Sandy Conley, and I have been involved in the arts for most of my life. My father was a commercial artist, and I believe when I was less than a year old, he put a paintbrush in my hand, and my destiny was set. But anyway, I did go to the Art Institute of Pittsburgh and had a career in commercial art before I had children. And then when life changed and I wasn't working full-time, I had the opportunity to take some classes and started into exploring the world of fine art. I was involved with watercolor for a long time, studied with Frank Webb and a number of other artists. And then for the last 10 years, I have been working with in a more traditional style of oil painting. And I studied with Kathleen Frost and do classical oil painting. And this piece right here is an example of my oil painting style. It's a simple still life. And simple is probably, I think, the best thing when you can take a few elements and show the beauty in all of those simple elements. I think that's the goal of most oil painters. But I really enjoy painting in that medium. In this show, I also have put a couple of pieces that are not in oil. They're in pastel. I've been in the last 3 or 4 years working in pastel as well. And I also have integrated something that's perhaps some of you older folks like me remember, something called Spirograph. And I rediscovered a Spirograph toy and started to play with that a few months ago. And you can perhaps see the detail in some of these two paintings where I have done some Spirograph motifs and then embellished them with animals and some other color and whatnot. So this one is called And So It Goes. It's kind of just a whimsical squirrel and the Spirograph, and I don't know quite what I had in mind other than whimsy. Then the next piece as well is kind of whimsy. I call it surprise, surprise. And again, there's a spirograph to begin with, and then I put a cat and a mouse kind of chasing one another. And the surprise of the mouse is that the cat is right around the corner. And the surprise for the cat is that the mouse is just as actually bigger than the cat. So I call it surprise, surprise. So I'm always trying to do something a little different and value imagination. I think that that's one of an artist's most important assets.
My name is Carol Kilcary, and I work... The majority of my work right now is in graphite. I retired 2 years ago and made myself join the Art League to get myself motivated and get around artists, get into this community. And I wanted to do everything. I've done a little bit of everything, oils, pastels, watercolor. I've done everything from portraits to painting motorcycles, but I wanted to start fresh. So I decided to go back to basics and I went to the pencil. And my goal is to be able to draw. I just want to be able to draw everything as best I can. I don't like subject matter that's what I call pretty. I try and draw things that have a little bit of a realistic crust to them, something out of the ordinary. And I sign my works Carol Motory because that's my maiden name. I feel my parents gave me the ability. My grandmother was a painter, but my husband gave me the opportunity to draw with retirement, so I guess I can't take credit for any of this. I'm slowly moving into color because the black and white has helped me so much understand light, dark, shadow, light in shadow, shadow in light, and so trying to translate that now into color. Currently working in oils, doing nudes. I like to do nudes, but I like to choose more angles that are very difficult. I don't like the normal front views, side views. I like to do the foreshortening, some very complicated angles and working. I guess I do majority of figures, but I like to be able to draw everything. That's my goal, just to be able to draw whatever I see and draw it well.
I would really like to thank all the artists who presented their works today. They were so interesting. I hope you enjoy the show as much as I did. And as always, please remember our troops that they return home safely and quickly. Thank you for watching.